Last evening, a building in Kabatu Zone, Kansanga, in Makindye Division collapsed, trapping dozens of people who were watching a football match at Loi Langa Restaurant and Cafe. The police, fire and rescue service rushed to the scene and immediately kicked off with rescue activities. According to the police, one person identified as Awie Paulino Mario, a South Sudanese national and proprietor of the restaurant, was killed in the accident while several others were injured.
We expect a team from the National Building Review Board, the engineers, to come and inspect the site. Hopefully we shall ascertain what exactly caused this. But as of now, we are not very much aware what caused the incident. It is very unfortunate that one person died.
This morning, the Uganda National Review Board kicked off an investigation into the likely cause of the incident. According to Herbert Ziwa, the Uganda National Review Board spokesperson, the proprietors of the collapsed building did not follow an approved plan and could have used substandard building materials.
Of technical officers, these are the engineers, the architects, came on ground early in the morning to find out what could have been the cause of the building that collapsed last evening. Preliminary investigations have so far found out that it is clear the developer was trying to modify the existing structure, which was a bungalow, by putting up rental or structures which were not properly designed. We've also found out that the materials being used in the modification of the existing structure were also of poor quality. We're also here to find out whether the developer had the necessary approvals from the KCCA, that is the Building Committee of KCCA, authorizing him or her to carry out the necessary modification of the existing structure.
Ziwa further advised Ugandans to ensure that building plans are approved before starting the construction works, as well as ensuring that they only employ certified and skilled engineers.
Many factors that lead to collapse of buildings. One of them is a failure to engage the professionals. Secondly, of course, the building materials. And you could also say the laxity on the side of the developers who want to say who want to reduce the costs at the expense of the safety of the buildings. So there are many causes of building accidents.
South Sudan's ambassador to Uganda, Simon Juach Deng, visited the collapsed building site and condoled with the bereaved families. He called for a thorough investigation into the incident.
This thing has really impacted on the community. We are calling on the Kampala City Council Authority and various departments of the government in Uganda to really take a thorough investigation to understand whether there were some structural defects.
Report by Disan Mutiaba for the news.